God stemning, masse mennesker og thai-mat. Kan det bli bedre? Nå skal vi se hvordan det når den thailandske ambassaden I Norge arrangerer Super Thai Friday. Ta og bli med meg! Why are we here today? What's the concept with the event?
Hi, today is the Royal Thai Embassy in collaboration with the Thai Airways organized the promotional food activities under the theme Thai flavors in Oslo, Super Thai Fridays. And you know, this year is so fantastic that we have such well-recognized local partners like Pla Restaurant and the Whippa working with us for bringing the taste of Thailand to the Norwegian lifestyle. The concept of doing this activity, we trying to promote Thai food with a more interactive and some lively way with the Norwegian touch. That's why what you see today is that we will merge the great flavors of Thailand with the best produce of Norway.
Hi.
Hei!
Hei. Hva det du spiser?
Det rull, da, men det fylt med grønnsaker.
Ja.
Og rispapir som de har lagt I vann og gjort myk før det har rullet den rundt. Da.
Ja. Og hva det du har spist?
Tortmannpla. Den thai.
Thai?
Fiskekake. Ja. Men litt stak og mye krydder.
Mye krydder. Hvordan det hjemme hos dere? Det mye sterk mat?
Kanskje 10 ganger sterkere enn her.
Hvor lenge har dere vært sammen nå?
10 år.
10 år?
Ja.
Og har det skjedd noen forandring etter 10 år? Har det blitt noen forandring I kjøleskapet?
Ja, hun spiser jo litt mer brød da. Og da blir det jo pålegg. Diverse forskjellige ting.
Men synes du nordmenn spiser for mye brød?
Ja, kanskje 3 ganger på dagen. Samme som mannen min, bare brød, brød, brød og brød.
Yeah, there's a lot of Norwegians who love to travel to Thailand, but do you have like a recommendation or a place that you would recommend Norwegians to go or travel to?
Well, that's actually a really hard question to actually say where to go in Thailand. There's so much for everyone, no matter what you like. If you like the mountains, you've got the northern part of Thailand. If you like the beaches, there's the south. You know, it's very popular, Phuket, Krabi, Samui. But what we're promoting now is also a lot of secondary cities that are lesser known and more undiscovered. And you've got the beaches there and everything as well. So it's hard to say what I like. I love Chiang Mai. I love Hua Hin, because all the people from Bangkok generally have a place in Hua Hin as well. But there's also Trat and all these islands all around Thailand that are still undiscovered. Don't stay in one place. You can just go to Bangkok, start in Bangkok, where you've got just about everything available to you then and make your way around.
What kind of dish did you try?
So we went for 3 different ones and we shared them. So we had the spicy, the spring rolls and the fish cakes and then the noodles with mussels and shrimp, I think. Yeah.
Was it spicy for you or was it okay?
I found, was it the fish cake sauce a little spicy, but he was fine.
I quite like spicy food. In terms of Thai and Indian food, I suppose there's roti in common, there's tamarind in common, and obviously it's kind of known for being a little bit spicy. But I think I really like kind of the lemongrass and other kind of flavors in Thai food. I think the general environment and nature, at least from what I've heard about it, seems to be very peaceful in Thailand, which you can't really have in a country of about 1 billion people. So slightly different.
Poke bowl, we had all the mussels. I was like, oh my god, we can do this. So tomorrow we're actually making a reindeer tartare with Thai flavors.
How did you end up here in Norway?
Yeah, so Chef Terrier was my customer. It was like 2 years ago,
and then
he came again last March, and then you know that time we actually talked a little bit about food that we do at the restaurant, and then really happy. You know, he got invited by him and Thai Embassy and Thai Airways, so Thank you again, and hopefully they invite me again.
But is it a challenge to adjust or to incorporate Norwegian ingredients with the Thai?
I mean, you know, like Thai no, like Norwegian ingredients already great by itself, you know. Like we don't need to do too much to it. For me, it was just making a little bit of vinaigrette here and there, and the ingredient itself, it just showcased itself already, you know.
With Norwegians, do you have to adjust the Thai flavors for the Norwegian taste, or like the spiciness, of course, maybe?
Well, we have a discussion about that, because we need to adjust a little bit on the spiciness, but I disagree about some dishes are spicy, so if you can't have the spices, this is not a dish for you, you know. It's hard, but it's I think because the dish needs the spiciness for sometimes.
Honestly, because you're Thai, what do you think about Thaddeus' food?
I just told him today I want to eat his food, because I look at the menu, I look at like, you know, the team of chefs that his team behind his team, actually, like, they're all passionate about it. There's a fresh chili just dropped by in today, and it's like each cook there, I just pick up one and bite to it. I'm like, as a Thai people, I'm like, whoa.
Do you have an advice or just a tip for a regular Norwegian guy or woman who wants to make Thai food? Is there a tip that you have?
A tip is it's no right or wrong. You know, it's whatever it is. When it comes down to flavors or the food, and I mean, it's like, this is a little example of like Thai issues. Like, they were talking about what actually pad kapow, or like a stir fry with Thai holy basil. Some people put beans, some people put carrot. For me, it's not the question that we need to ask for the food. It's no right or wrong. If your mother make with carrots, then that's your pad kapow for you.
So when do we see the first collaboration between Thailand and Norway in Bangkok?
Well, hopefully soon. I think it's very fun to do this. This is the first time I've done here in Oslo. And I would love to do it in Bangkok as well, maybe with him and so on. And I would love to have all the ingredients there. And I think I've learned so much during these 2 days about Thai food and about and also about our own food, because he has looked with other eyes on our food, and that could happen again and the other way in Bangkok. So it's been really interesting and really learning and educational for us, for all my staff, and everyone has said this is very fun to do. So I'd love to do it again in Bangkok.
As a professional, what do you think about Thai food?
I mean, the Thai cuisine is such a huge range of dishes and flavors. Obviously for Europeans, it can sometimes be a slightly unreachable cuisine because it is so spicy. And in Europe, we can't handle it very well, mostly. However, it has such a vast range of foods, flavors. I think it's one of the most interesting in the world, especially when it comes to the use of spices, because they really involve so many different levels of spice in there that, yeah, as I said, most of us here in Europe can't even handle, but I think it's absolutely fantastic.
Je vais bien. C'est plus vieux, meaning it's raining outside. C'est plus vieux.
Hi.
Hi!
What did you order?
I ordered some dumplings. So this one is the veggie one, and this one is the pork one. So yummy, yummy!
Enjoy!
Thank you!